So do you believe that what you do is classier than stripping?
I don't like to say one is classier than the other, because I've seen people in the strip club that are classy.
Right.
So it's just up to the person who's looking at it. Mm-hmm. Everybody kind of gets to decide and make that judgment for themselves.
Right.
But I don't like to put one above the other, because at the end of the day, you working in the strip club, you're just working. You're doing what you got to do. Now, if you're doing stuff inside of that strip club that brings you down or brings your energy down, that's something completely different. But you just dancing on the stage or giving somebody a lap dance, I really don't think anything big of that.
Right.
It's okay.
Yeah.
So I don't like to put the strippers down and the pole dancers above, because we're all just women out there getting. Some people work in a strip club just so they have the opportunity to actually be on stage and express their art form. Some girls don't even do lap dances. So there's actually bikini bars where people just dance on the stage, go back in the back, come out on the stage, and they walk around and maybe talk to guys, but they're not doing any lap dances and not having sex in the back.
How you make your money if you're not doing lap dances?
Depends on the club that you work at. So there are some clubs that tip really good on stage, and then there's other clubs where you gotta do back. You gotta do back
dances. So there are men that will tip without you having sex or putting your ass on them?
Uh-huh.
Really?
Yeah. I saw a girl eat pizza on stage and made about $100+. Literally. She made eating pepperoni pizza look sexy. I was like, how?
To make a order.
While she's slithering around on the floor. I thought it was hot. I even tipped her $5. I was like, how are you doing this right now?
Well, how'd you get the name Nicole the Pole? Did you come up with that?
I did not. It was back on Facebook. Let's see. I started pole dancing in 2009. I think around 2011, I probably got that name. Somebody said it on Facebook one day, and it just stuck.
Okay. it's good. It's good.
And it rhymes.
When you do your dancing, do you twerk? Do you drop it like it's hot? Do you do all of that?
I do all of that.
Yeah.
Like when I perform with Snoop, one of the songs we dance to is Drop It Like It's Hot. So on that song, you know, we get a little ratchet on that song.
Girl, I was in a Snoop Dogg video.
Mm-hmm.
I was in a Snoop Dogg when I first moved to LA.
Uh-huh.
I was in a Snoop Dogg video. They shot it at his house in Diamond Bar.
Uh-huh.
And I had on these really, really tight leather pants, right? I can't remember the song for the life of me, but I bent down to drop it like it's hot, and my pants split right down the middle. And that was the end of my video days right there. But Bishop Don Juan, you know, he tried to get it in. You know, he tried to recruit. Do you find that pimps try to recruit you?
So, funny story. Bishop Don Juan used to live right by my studio, because my studio was on Pico.
And, of course he did.
And so he actually came by a few times to say hi. But that was it. He was actually very nice.
He is a very nice
guy. Super nice guy, yeah.
I interviewed him on my radio show, and I asked him what he called the women that he'd hold out and apologize to them, because he said that he messed up a lot of women. He admitted to messing up a lot of women. I don't know if he's still a pimp or not, but he certainly carries the persona.
Yes.
And so he said, yeah, I'll call him, but I don't have nobody's phone number.
he just shows up on people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Hmm.